It is time to cable and install my SimpliVity 325 node pair, ready for action, with the newly released software version 4.1, right after this. Hi, I'm Marcus. This is where we talk everything about enterprise IT, from bare metal to cloud native. If you are into that sort of stuff, please consider subscribing. Thanks. Last time we unboxed this SimpliVity 325 nodes. If you haven't seen that one yet, by the way, take a look at it right here. This time we are going to do the installation, including cabling and software deployment. I will also give you a few tips how to avoid some of the mistakes I made during the installation. Oh, what's this? You must be wondering. This is a USB stick, but not just any USB stick. It's a USB stick with the long-awaited SimpliVity 4.1, which will be announced just about right now. That's right, I got an early access to the software well before the release. Big kudos to HPE SimpliVity team for that. And so, in the end of the video, we are going to talk about the main features of the new software version 4.1. Also, kudos to HPE for sponsoring this video. If you want to jump to a specific chapter, you'll find all the timestamps from the description below. All right, let's take a look at everything we need for a successful installation. From the hardware point of view, the minimum SimpliVity configuration, which I have here, consists of four hardware components. Two SimpliVity nodes, one standard server, and one switch. You'll also need a bunch of software that you can download from HPE Software Center. You'll get quite a few files with the download package, but at this stage, we're only interested in three of them. SimpliVity Deployment Manager, Arbiter, and SimpliVity plugin for vSphere client. Additionally, you need to have a supported VMware vCenter server appliance running before you start the deployment. That's why we need the extra server here. Before we can do the cabling, one thing to remember, SimpliVity 325 Gen 10 does not ship with the 1 gig Ethernet card that's needed for management. So you'll need to remember to order this card separately. Doesn't cost anything, but just be sure to include it in the configuration. Okay, let's cable these things. We have four types of cables here. First, 2x25 gig direct attach cables, or DACs, for direct connecting the two nodes. And this is actually one of the main attractions of SimpliVity for small environments. If you only have two nodes like I do, you don't need an expensive 10 or 20 gig switch. You just direct connect two cables and that's it. Super easy. Now, if you use larger than two node clusters or any other brand HEI solution, you'll need to invest in a serious switch like this monster. Don't get me wrong, it's super cool, but it's quite overkill and sets you back worth of a summer car. Next, connecting the three ILO cables to whatever 1 gig switch you have lying around. No special requirements. Just FYI, SimpliVity ILOs are not set to DHCP like ProLiant normally. Instead, they have a fixed IP. Then, the three VMware management cables for all three servers to the same switch. I'm using only one cable per server in my demo environment, but of course, you should be using at least two in production. And lastly, the power cables. Again, I'm using only one cable per server here. Do not try that in production. That's it. Cabling is done. Can't be much more straightforward. Makes a two-node SimpliVity 325 cluster ideal for edge deployments with limited staff and space. Time to boot up the SimpliVity nodes. Software deployment starts with vCenter installation, which is already up and running for me here. Just a heads up, vCenter appliance is the only supported vCenter version with SimpliVity these days. No more Windows vCenters. Then let's install the SimpliVity Deployment Manager on any computer in the same network as vCenter. I'm using my daily driver Windows 10 PC right over there, so I'm gonna install it on there. Installation is a next Windows app installation, nothing special here. Next, Arbiter. This one is a bit special, and it's required only with two node clusters to act as a tiebreaker in split brain situations where communication between the two nodes have been lost, and both of those nodes think they are the only storage nodes alive. Someone needs to make a decision which one will be servicing production, and that someone is Arbiter. You don't need Arbiter with clusters more than two nodes, it's recommended, but not required. Arbiter can also be installed on whatever Windows machine on the same network, so I'm installing it on my PC again. Last, SimpliVity plugin for vCenter. This one adds SimpliVity management features to the vCenter user interface. Installing the plugin is a bit more complicated. You'll need to SCP the installation package to the vCenter server and then run a few Linux commands. By no means I'm a Linux guru, but following the deployment guide got me through pretty much the installation with no problems. Now we are all set for the actual deployment. On the login page of the deployment manager, you'll actually see the first new 4.1 feature, deployment precheck. It's the same configuration validation tool that's been there forever, but now you can access it directly and validate your environment for smooth deployment without the need to go through all the deployment steps first. By no means this validation is 100% accurate. It does not notice all imaginable problems, but it surely helps a lot. So, after login, it's time to enable InfoSight support, because why not? Select vCenter cluster, number of nodes, Arbiter location. If you have saved a configuration file earlier, you can choose to use it here to speed up the deployment. But we'll do everything from scratch, so manually entering the settings. Now, we need to find the two SimpliVity nodes. You can check the node IP addresses from the ILO remote console, where the nodes are waiting to be discovered after the boot. Since SimpliVity 4.1 now supports vSphere 7, let's choose that as a hypervisor to be deployed on the nodes. I will choose the one available 1 gig connection to be used as the ESX management connection, and I will choose only one of the 25 gig connections to be used for storage and federation traffic for now. You should choose both 25 gig connections, but I just wanted to test if it goes through with one. By the way, it does. Setting some passwords for the nodes. MTU for management network should be 1500. Setting management network gateways and subnets according to my network settings, and since I'm using a flat network, I will be using VLAN 0. For two nodes, we'll need 4 free management IP addresses. 2 for ESX hosts themselves, and 2 for the virtual storage controllers. Let's use a 10 network here. Then onto the storage network settings. We want to use jumbo frames for storage traffic, so we'll set the MTU to 9000. Gateways are optional, but subnet is mandatory. Now, this is where I wanted to cut corners and used IP addresses from the same network as with the management. Do not do that. Deployment will fail, trust me. Just come up with a new network or VLAN for storage. So I'm using a 20 network for storage here. The same goes for the Federation network. Set MTU to 9000 and use a third network. Next up, domains. I don't have any existing domains in my network, and I'm anyway out of imagination, so I will just use the example domains from the deployment guide. And since I don't have domains set up, let's uncheck the find and register the host by domain name. Choose at least 3 NTP servers from the list, or type your own if you have some available. By the way, talking about NTP servers, be sure to synchronize time using NTP servers with your vCenter too. Preferably use the same ones you're using with the SimpliVity nodes. Summary of the settings. Everything looks good. So off we go to testing the host settings. Some steps will be skipped since they don't apply to my setup. And there's one caution about accelerator card missing. This is fine since SimpliVity 325 does not have a physical accelerator card, but uses software acceleration. So just ignore that. In my opinion, doesn't sound like worthy a caution at all. If you're listening, HP. So, all good? Moving forward. Since the configuration seems to be okay, let's save the configuration file for the future, and then starting the deployment. This bit is 48 steps total and took some 25 minutes for me, and overall the whole process with software installation is about an hour. If you don't do anything foolish, like I did, then it's going to be 2 days. So, here's the story that leads to my most important lesson learned. Always, always, always check the installation package integrity. So My notes shipped with software version 4.01 and I needed to upgrade them to 4.1. I did that using the deploy installer image file. So I upgraded the notes, but after the first boot, everything went haywire. I started to get all kinds of weirdness, like ILO virtual media not connecting and close to half an hour node boot up times. After trying to troubleshoot this for a day or so, I decided to contact SimpliVity support. And one of the first things they asked me to do is validate the file integrity. With every file in the SimpliVity software download package, you'll get an SHA-256 file to validate the file integrity. There are plenty of software for calculating the hash. I used Win32 disk imager. Turned out, the installation package was indeed totally corrupted. No idea what and when happened, but it did. Took a while to get the nodes up and running again, but I can say that I would not have managed without SimpliVity support. I have to say that I've been in contact with quite a few support entities during my career, but SimpliVity support experience was by far, hands down, the best I've ever had. So one more time, thank you SimpliVity team for a superb support. That's it. SimpliVity 325 cluster up and running. So, the big news. HPE is finally releasing the new SimpliVity software version, version 4.1. It's been more than a year since the last update, so I'm sure this will be a very welcome update for many. The first enhancement is cloud volume backups. SimpliVity has the awesome inbuilt backup capability, but now it's possible to backup SimpliVity data also to the cloud. Perfect for hybrid environments. Talking about backups, the second improvement with this new software version is StoreOnce backups over WAN networks. Especially useful for edge locations to do backups with the centralized StoreOnce instance. Related to that, SimpliVity can now optimize the network performance for backups. It's doing this by throttling the production bandwidth during the backup processes. Also, with software version 4.1, SimpliVity gets the support for CSI plugin, giving SimpliVity container ammunition. Lastly, as I already mentioned, SimpliVity now supports the latest vSphere version 7. Talking about updates, there's also a new disk configuration available for SimpliVity 380G, a 24 SSD version with 32 terabytes of storage capacity. Should be plenty. Phew, that was a lot. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and if you did, give me a like and see you with the next one.